We all want a blessing. There are different types of blessings. There are blessings you get, but don't reach you. And then there is the blessing. 60 letters, 15 words. Birkat Kohanim, the blessing of the priests. The Sephardic Jews do it every day. The Ashkenazic Jews do it every holiday. What's so powerful about this blessing? Ad mehera yahutz devaro. Our sages teach us that the blessing of the Kohanim is one that goes through and through, quickly reaches the person that is receiving the blessing. Not only that, when the Kohanim are blessing the people, afilu mechitza shel barzel, even an iron wall is not able to block the blessing, and it's able to go through and reach the person. Yevarechecha Hashem veishmerecha. May you be blessed and may you be protected. Rashi says you should be blessed with children, you should be blessed with wealth, and you should be protected, that wealth should not be stolen by robbers or thieves. And the same thing spiritually speaking. When you have a spiritual blessing, you don't want, this should be what's called yenikat achitzonim. The negative forces should benefit of the holy blessings you just received. Ya'er Hashem panav elecha v'chuneka. May God show His countenance to you and grace you. What is that blessing? A very special blessing. The blessing of having grace. Yosef HaTzadik had grace on him. And therefore, Vayi Hashem et Yosef, Vayish Matzliach, wherever he went, he was successful because he had the grace of Hashem with him. But here, the Alter Rebbe explains, the word vichuneka, which means to be graced, could be interpreted from the same root as the word vayichan sham Yisrael. They encamped there, meaning to say that God should show His countenance to you and it should stay with you. That's the most difficult. We get upset sometimes. We have different moods. The blessing and the grace of Hashem, the countenance of Hashem should accompany you. And finally, Yisa Hashem panav elecha. God should show you favor. When you, our sages teach us, say Birkat Hamazon, you say Birkat Hamazon even on a small quantity of food, which shows that really, even though the Torah taught you that you need to be full in order to thank Hashem, you, as a Jew, took upon yourself to say Birkat Hamazon even on a small quantity of bread. And therefore, since you show favor to God, God shows you favor in exchange. Yisa Hashem panav elecha, He will show you favor, v'yasem lecha shalom, and He will give you peace. What's peace in the world? Every one of us has a soul and a body, and we are involved with physical matter. All of this physical matter has godly sparks. When we say blessings, we actually reveal the godly sparks and we benefit of the blessings. Sometimes we could stray away and be so involved in materialism and physicality that we forget the purpose why we acquired these physical things. To this, God says, Yisa Hashem panav elecha. God will show you favor, will continue His blessing on you. V'yasem lecha shalom. And it will be in a way that you find inner peace, not in a way that distracts you from your mission. So, have a good day. Shabbat shalom and be blessed.